Hi, welcome back. And here we are sitting with the members of our panel 2, which focused around why we need more women in technology. It is a dire situation. It is the need of the hour. And we have these panelists going to be talking to you about it. I was in the auditorium when you began the discussion, and there was a large number of women in technology who were there. So that's amazing, because if women are looking to come back and you have companies that are offering you the support you need to, there's no reason why you should stay back. To start with, I'm going to introduce our panelists. We have with us Reema Jain, IT Director, Global EBI Platform and ERP Application Management at Unilever. We have Harjeet Pruthi, Senior Program Manager, VMware India, who was also the moderator of the panel. And we have Sreekanth, Arimanithaya, Global Talent Leader, EYGDS. To begin with, I'll start with Harjeet. Harjeet, since you are in the field yourself, can you tell us what it is that companies are doing today to bring women back in the field of technology? And I am aware that VMware has a program around this to encourage this initiative. So if you can speak on this.
Thank you, Kajal. So hi, guys. Yes, we do have a program, and the program is called VM Inclusion Tara. The objective is for women who are currently on a career break to give them free technical education and training on VMware products and services, so that it gives them their first stepping stone to come back to work. So this is open to women who are currently on a career break for 6 months or more. They are citizens of India and residing in the territorial jurisdiction of India. If you fit that category, all you have to do is go to vmware.com/Tara, sign up and start learning today, because we have given you a flexibility to learn this training self-paced and online. It is absolutely free of cost, and that is one way we would like 15,000 women in India to come back to work via the Tara program. And VMware, as you know, are being used by organizations across India. We have both customers sitting right next to me. One is from EY and one is from Unilever. And they, of course, are using VMware products. So when you do graduate, you have a plethora of opportunities available for you. So look it up, and all the best. Thank you.
Thanks, Harjeet. So Sreekanth, coming to you, maybe if you want to share something about what you said inside the auditorium as well, a learning that our women can take. But as we said earlier, right, there is a certain lack or dip in the number of women in technology today. There's a reason behind it. Why do you think that's happening? Why do you think women in STEM are depleting and are not even encouraged to get into the field? What do you think needs to be done to bring them back or even to onboard new women?
Thank you. That's a great question. The first of all, women need to look at career beyond corporate. That's what I was talking in the panel also. This career includes, you can start up your own ventures. And I've seen many women who are entrepreneurs are very successful compared to men. The second one is you can definitely pursue career in corporates. And the third one is women can really pursue career as freelancers. Today, close to 100 freelancing platforms are there. Out of that, 30% to 40% are technology career paths available, whether it's in Kaggle for big data and analytics, Appen for ML and AI, or coding or testing or architecturing like Upwork or Topcoder, or for testing like Qualtrics and Applause. So please look at career beyond traditional corporate is the first advice I'll give you. The second one, when you pursue career in technology career path, there are three C's I call it as very important. The C, the capital C, the alphabet C. The first one is the competency. You need to constantly upgrade competency as a woman or a man leader. It is so important to be relevant in today's industry. And these competencies are not only technology competencies like social, mobile, cloud, analytics, ML, AI, chatbot, gamification, or IoT or blockchain. But beyond that, some of the digital methodologies like design thinking, agile, continuous integration, innovation, creativity. So these are equally important. I believe a lot of women bring this soft side, the methodologies, competencies much better compared to the male. The second one is when you acquire these competencies, today the, what you call it as microservice architecture are producing micro task, and micro task are producing micro skills, and micro skills are producing micro learning. So there are a lot of micro tasks available in crowdsourcing platform in form of service catalog. And if you go and look at the service catalog, it requires only 2 weeks of micro skilling. You already have foundation technology. With the 2 weeks of micro skilling, you can do this micro task. So don't worry that you are losing if you are on a maternity leave or if you have taken some sabbatical to take care of your family. Keep on looking at micro skills, looking at the micro service catalogs. So that's the, on the competency. The second C is the capacity. I think as a women leader, you need to build capacity around you. And one of the panel member was talking about the what do you call it as the sports, what the analogy used it is in a pit stop. Exactly. So if you really look at, you know, sometimes you have to take a small breaks or a medium breaks in career to have a long-term career in technology and organization. So do not feel guilty whenever you take small breaks that I'm losing something. But actually you can gain a larger momentum when you take a break and come with more energy to the organization. So that's one example of capacity. Like always I believe, if you want to play football, you need to know the skills of football, that is competency. But you need to bring a lot of energy by doing regular exercise and build stamina. That is for me is capacity. A small breaks and bringing flexi working hours, alternative working arrangements, all around building capacity for women leaders. Please understand the capacity industry pays and use it, including small breaks. The last one is the confidence. The last C is a confidence. You have the competency, you have the capacity, but you don't have the confidence to lead in the organization, the confidence to face the customer, confidence to make a big technology team leading it virtually across the globe. The confidence is very important. Again, I have seen women leaders or male leaders developing pseudo confidence. For example, we say that, oh, my manager is very good, he always give me flexibility. Or I have a mother-in-law in my home who is always ready to take my kids when I'm going to office. And this is a kind of a pseudo confidence, but the real confidence is build a network of people beyond your solid line managers. So whenever you are in need, you can really rely on network. Similarly, of course, mother-in-law is a great resource for you, but build network beyond mother-in-law. And so that when you are in need, you can plug into this network and they can take, you know, help you in your personal career. So the three C's, the competency, the capacity, and the confidence is essential in pursuing technology career. And one cannot replace, and you need to have all the three together to make it successful in the industry. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much, Sreekanth. For some reason, I didn't feel like I was talking to a man. It very much felt like there was a woman in the conversation, because you touched upon all those little things that matter in a woman's career journey. My next question is for Reema. Reema, you're at such a senior position in your career, and which means you have dedicated those many years to your career. Being at that senior level position, can you tell us what you did to deal with hurdles that come your way? For example, it could be a career break, it could be a role that you had to take up because your personal life had to take precedence over. Can you tell us how you dealt with that? And to actually keep you motivated in your work, what was that extra bit that you had to probably do?
So, you know, all of us have to make, you know, choices, right? We want to have it all, but we have to, you know, life is about making choices, right? Sometimes the choices are big, like not going for a promotion or, you know, taking a break in the career. Sometimes choices are small, maybe not attending show and tell of your daughter, or maybe not going for the family get together. So we always have these, you know, choices, and you gain something, you lose something, right? There are always trade-off. What is important is once you have made a choice, you know, to stick with your choice. You know, make sure, you know, you have that confidence in you that that's the right choice we have made. And make sure you don't regret back and come back and revisit, okay, why did I make that choice, right?